Hello students, now we'll have a look on one of the chapter of module 5, that is input and interaction. Then we'll go back for module 4. Myself Sunanda Brother. So let us look into some of the theoretical parts. I'll go quickly because that you can understand easily whenever it comes for programming and difficult concepts. I'll explain in detail. So this particular chapter introduces you with the basic input devices, which can be called as physical devices, logical devices, and also we are studying about the inputs. We are talking about event driven inputs, and we also are going to see about how to make use of double buffering for smooth animation, and also we'll see mainly the programs on event driven input along with the glut. So device can be represented or described by either their physical properties or their logical properties. Physical properties like by appearance, by the way work, we classify them into mouse, keyboard, trackball, so and so. Logically, what they are returning to a program through certain application program interface, like whether they are returning a position, whether they are identifying any object, whether they are identifying any particular part of the screen. So these we are going to see. Modes, how and when the input is obtained, whether automatically immediately after attaching the device to the program or on particular event has happened, like after clicking or after resizing, something like that. So physical input devices, we know that these all are the physical input devices: mouse, trackball, light fin, data tablet, joystick, space bar, and so on. So logically, this is one of the important question, theoretical question that comes under this particular chapter, that is the different classes of logical input devices. So we can logically classify the devices into six categories, that is locator, which returns a position, pick, which selects or returns the ID, pick is selection, right, string, which returns the strings of characters, stroke returns the array of positions, valuator returning floating point number, trace returns one of the NI types. So logically, locator, which returns a position, can be a mouse, isn't it? Pick, we are selecting one among many, right? It can be a menus drop down list which are selected through a particular mouse. String, we can say like keyboard is a string device, like arrest of positions are returned again by a mouse. Valuator return floating point number, particularly values are important. Choice, among n number of choices, one is selected through the physical device mouse. You can also see that in many of these cases, either we are using a keyboard or mouse. Based on their work and what they return, we are classifying them into different categories, isn't it? Say mouse is returning a position also, mouse is used to select one of the n items also. So here the same physical device is used, but the work done by that is different. So based on their what they return, we are classifying logically into six types. So we have the details of this in the textbook also. Input device, it contain a trigger, input modes we are talking about. So input devices usually contain a trigger which can be used to send a signal to the OS, like button on the mouse, pressing or releasing a key of the keyboard. So these are all the triggers through which we are sending certain signals to the OS. Like say, I pressed A, I press left click, I press enter key. So these are all keys or buttons are the triggers through which we are sending the signal to the OS. So when triggers, when we are triggering through these triggers, input devices are returning the information. They are measuring, they are sending the measurement to the system. Mouse returns the position information wherever it is placed. Keyboard are returning the ASCII code of the key which we have pressed, right? So we have mainly three modes. First, we'll have a look on request mode. Input is provided to the program only when the user has triggered the device, only when certain key is pressed. So this we call as a what, request mode. So trigger is required only when certain key is pressed. Triggerer is starting a measurement process. The measurement is sent to the program. So the way it works is simple. a program will be there which is requesting a measuring process. So this measuring process happens only when it is triggered by certain triggering process, right? Then the measurement is sent to the program. Okay, then we'll go for the sample mode. Input is immediate, you need not have to trigger anything. Like as soon as the function call is executed in the user program, then the measure is returned. Hence no trigger is needed. So simply a program is started running that particular function, then it is getting a measurement. So you can just compare this diagram with the previous diagram. Only this part is present. No trigger process is present here. Okay. So event mode. Most of the systems have more than one input device, each of which can be triggered at arbitrary time by user. For example, I may control a one particular program through keyboard as well as mouse also. So I am attaching multiple devices to that particular program. So each trigger, when I press a key, then it is generating a different event. When I press one of the button on mouse, it may be generating another event. So even event mode, based on what we have pressed, the particular action takes place, that we call as in an event queue, which can be examined by the user program. You can see that a program which has a support of multiple events, it has to wait for the multiple events, and this event is resulting into a measure process, and that measure process is triggered also. So you can observe here it is involving event plus trigger mode also, request mode also, an additional is event mode, right? Event types, yeah, that is what we are looking mainly in this particular chapter. That is event types we are going to see. Like if it is a window, we have a resize, expose and iconify. Like in the corner of any window, we will be having the resize button, minimize button. So these are all the different events we can do it on a window, right? So when it is resized, I want to make it back to the original size, that is the expose. Mouse, through click one or more buttons. Motion is another event. I can move the mouse. If mouse is moved here, some action should take place. Keyboard, pressing or releasing a key. See, when we press, pressing of one key involves two events, that is pressing and releasing both. So doing nothing is also another event which can be measured. Being idle itself is again another event type. Client and server, if a computer graphics is useful for a variety of real applications, it must function well in world of distributed computing and networks. You can observe that you have a common bus to which number of servers are attached, to which one of them is graphics server, and you know that workstations are very commonly used in computer graphics, so, and they are costlier as well, so we can make use of them in a network manner. One of the way how the computer graphics is used is through display list, which illustrates how we can use the clients and servers on a network. You can just observe, this is achieved through something called as a display processor and a display file, rather than having a single machine which is not in the network, and having a standalone machine, we want to perform it in a network because of a heavy cost of a workstation and the display processor. The display processor is a graphics server, and the user program on the host computer is a client file. We can send the graphical entities to a display in one of the two ways. One is immediate mode and retained mode. So that is, immediate is as soon as the program is executed by the request is sent by the client, and graphics program is getting executed on the server's machine, immediately the output is displayed on the client's machine. That is immediate mode. Retained is kept with the server, only when required it is sent back, right? That is what disadvantages associated the that is the what advantages, like you can define the object once and it can, display lists are used for this. You can define the object once and then a display list can be called several times to create same kind of objects. So disadvantages associated with require more memory of the server. There is an overhead for creating a display list also. So we'll see how to define and execute a display list in the next video lecture.